transgender person. I'm not a typical transgender person. None of them are typical, but together we're all typical. We have three transgender folks in the middle, and we have two parents of transgender people on the end. And I'm just going to first start by just asking everybody to take a half a minute or a minute to just introduce yourself. And if it's okay, could I start with the transgender people? Could I start with Eli, go down to Kathy, and then come back up to David? Is that all right? Wonderful. Eli, do you mind starting? And you can tell us, tell us your name, where you live, what else there's interesting about you in terms of your transitudinous.
Transitudinous.
Transitivity. Sorry.
Transitivity. All right, either way. My name's Eli, everybody. I grew up in a really small town in northern Wisconsin, and it took me a long time to be able to transition. I was 36 when I decided to take testosterone and change my body to match my brain. And it's been a wonderful experience for me. I'm much happier. I've lived in Alaska for 4 years. Feel like I've had minimal issues since my transition, so that's been great. I have a lot of support from my family, minus my sister, but it's been a great thing for me, and I'm much happier.
Originally from Chicago, I grew up in Chicago. I left Chicago when I was 19, and I knew that there was not a safe place for me to transition. And I moved to Seattle, which was a much safer place at the time. And I've lived in Tennessee for 5 years, and I've been in Alaska for 7. Alaska has not been one of the hardest places that I've ever lived in. It's not been one of the easiest either. I can tell you a lot more about that later. Thanks.
I'm CJ. I'm a trans male. I identify as genderqueer as well. I've been actively transitioning since I was 14 years old, but even before that, I always knew that something didn't sit quite right with me. Presenting as female, people thinking I was female was always wrong. So now that I've transitioned to where I want to be, I'm a lot happier of a person, comfortable expressing myself, being who I want to be, and I'm here to help the people who aren't yet comfortable with themselves and, you know, fight this initiative so that we can get the rights we need.
Hi everyone. My name's Kathy, and I am a nearly lifelong Alaskan. I grew up here, moved here in the mid-70s with my family. I loved growing up here. I flew around with my dad, I fished, I hunted, camped, enjoyed the beauty of Alaska, the wildness of Alaska, and the independence of the people here. When I fell in love, about 20 years ago and got married, I left the state, and I was in the state of Colorado for a little while I had my babies. And after I had 2 babies, my husband and I started feeling a little restless, and Alaska beckoned, and I thought, what better place to raise my kids than the place I grew up with, the people I know and the community I love? So we came back, and that was in 2004. For a long time, my life went according to plan, pretty much. And about 4 years ago, I had to reframe my expectations for my family and for my children. So instead of thinking about piano lessons, gymnastics, fiddle lessons, honor roll, I was thinking about discrimination and violence against my youngest child. The reason that reality came to our family is because my youngest child is transgender. And if you don't really understand what transgender means, join the club. There is not one definition. There is not one type, or one look, or one appearance, or one attitude for trans people. But I can tell you that trans people are us. They are Anchorage. They are our community and our families and our friends. Imagine my relief when 2 years ago we worked diligently not only to understand my child's reality, but to get to know this part of the community that I honestly knew nothing about before my son came up to me. Anchorage Assembly passed that non-discrimination ordinance. That was a huge burden lifted from my heart. I was able to breathe and believe that my children and children like him were going to be protected and treasured and kept safe. And if all of you look within your hearts, you will know that that is what we want for all of our children, to be treasured and valued and safe. So we had the victory, the relief, the gratitude to my Anchorage community for supporting my child. And imagine our dismay when there were enough signatures gathered on an initiative to bring to a vote whether or not my child is protected. And I know I'm probably going over the time, but I really want to stress, I understand that this is a confusing issue for a lot of people, and it's hard to think about. But what I want to ask you to do is open your hearts and your minds. Embrace an attitude of learning. Learn about your neighbors, the children of your friends, the people you may work with. And even if the transgender community isn't directly in your inner circle of friends, imagine the impact that you can make if you speak up for living in a community that does not condone discrimination based on fear and misstatements and inaccuracies. Imagine being that advocate that doesn't have a vested interest like I do with my child, but someone who really cares about Anchorage and how we move forward. This is an historical time for us. It's critical that we pull together and that we make our voices heard. And I'm asking you, as a mom and an Anchorage citizen, to please learn and please speak up. Thank you.
I have a husband, father, an engineer, pretty typical Anchorage guy. I like to hunt and fish, and most of the time my dog's got me doing what he wants because he's a big manipulator. But I guess what might be meaningful in this context is I'm the kind of person that I hope you will reach out to with regards to Proposition 1, because until I had a transgender son, I didn't know what it meant to be transgender. And the kinds of things that are in Proposition 1 and the issues around being transgender, they were confusing to me, and I didn't think about them much. But I love my family, and I love my friends, and they influence me. And I think there is a really large percentage of Anchorage that is like I was then, and you can reach them. And that's what I'm going to be working on doing the next few months.
So, thank you, everybody. So we have some transplants here, and we have some folks who were raised here. And I'm wondering, this is a sort of a fuzzy question, but I'm wondering how you feel about POP 1. If you're yet worried, or you feel unsafe because of it, or are you glad there's a public education opportunity, or what are your thoughts about it? I know that's a sort of a big, vague question, but who would like to start? It is.
Actually, I am afraid of it, and I've been afraid of it ever since, well, even actually before it even came to Anchorage, when it first started in South Carolina. And the timing of it, which you brought up before, because it happened right after the Marriage Equality Act passed, and they kind of targeted the most vulnerable society of the whole alphabet soup thing, the LGBTQA community, which is us. We've always been the quietest of the whole list, and we've always been more laid back and to ourselves. And I remember there were times when I used to hear people complaining about the gay and lesbian community, and they would say things like, well, I don't really mind gays and lesbians, but why do they always have to put it up in our face? To me, when they brought along Proposition 1, they brought it up to our face. And this is something that we didn't ask for. We didn't go seeking, and we pretty much still try to stay to ourselves and, kind of hush-hush for the most part. But my thought is now it's on.
I grew up in a really small town, and I didn't even understand what a trans person was until I had college. And at that point, I kind of went, oh shit, that's me. And I wasn't ready. I was too afraid. I wasn't comfortable enough with myself. I just didn't have the strength in me to take hormones and transition, and I didn't have any positive role models. I'm 38 now, so this is 20 years ago. It took me a long time to finally get comfortable and finally realize and meet some amazing positive role models, especially here in Alaska, before I had the courage to say, I'm just gonna be so much happier if I do this. I'm gonna be true to myself, I'm gonna finally feel good. It took a long time for me.